Hello children, in our previous video we divided x cube minus 2 x squared minus 4 by x minus 3, and this was our quotient and this was our remainder. We just want you to compare this with a numerical division, a simple numerical division. Say we divide 23 by 3, you just get 3, 7 times is 21, so your remainder is 2 here, isn't it? This is the remainder and this is the quotient in this case. So now I can write the division fact as 23 is equal to the product of 7 and 3 plus the remainder, right, where 7 is your quotient and 2 is your remainder. So this is a general fact which all of us know for numerical division. This is called the division fact also. The same can be applied to this polynomial division, isn't it? So in the place of 23, here you have x cube minus 2x squared minus 4. This can be expressed as a product of the quotient. Here it is 7, here the quotient is x squared plus x plus 3 multiplied by the what we divide with, x minus 3, right? X minus 3 plus the remainder, here it is 5. Okay, so this is the division fact for polynomial division. And this holds good for any polynomial. Whatever polynomial is given to you, you can express it as a product of the quotient. You can divide any polynomial. So you can express it as a product of the quotient into any linear polynomial, x minus a, so plus the remainder. The remainder is also a polynomial in x, right? So R of x. Now, you may wonder, I am calling x minus a as a linear polynomial, and we have always studied that the linear polynomial is of this form, isn't it? Hx plus k, ax plus b, whatever. But for convenience purposes, here I am taking the coefficient of x to be a. Even if it was in the form hx plus k, we can divide it by h, s plus k by h. And maybe even this h can be multiplied to q of x, and still we can say that this can be represented as x minus a. This is also a linear polynomial. So you will understand why we are using this form, x minus a form of the linear polynomial, as we go further. So now I hope this is clear to you till here, q of x into x minus a plus r of x. But since we mentioned specifically that this is a linear polynomial, the remainder has to be at least lesser than 1, because linear polynomial degree is 1. So this has to be of degree lesser than the linear polynomial, isn't it? So lesser than 1 means it's degree 0, which is a constant. It's a 0 polynomial means it's a constant. So you can just write it as R. So I rewrite the same equation, p of x is equal to q of x into x minus a plus r. This holds good for any value of x. This term, this is just a division fact, nothing else. This is just like this, a numerical division fact, and this is a division fact. It holds good for any x. Means it has to hold good for, if I take x is equal to a, it has to hold good for p of a also. Is it just that we have to replace the value of x by a? So p of a is equal to q of a into a minus a plus r. And look at what we got here. You've got a minus a, which is 0. So if a minus a is 0, you multiply q of a by 0. Whatever be the value of your quotient, this whole term becomes 0. So 0 plus r. P of A is equal to 0 plus R, which gives you the conclusion that P of A is equal to R. And this is our remainder theorem. This is what our remainder theorem says, that a polynomial, if when divided by the linear polynomial x minus a, the remainder is equal to the value of this polynomial at. This is what our remainder theorem says, right? I hope you understood. Thank you. We have proved the remainder theorem in a very simple way. at P of A is equal to R. I hope you understood. Thank you.